Okay, so we are going to talk about the network topologies. Okay, so we have basically lots of network topologies. We have bus topology, right? We have link topology, we have star topology, right? We have extended star topology. We have also the hierarchical topology. We have also mesh topology, right? But let's talk about that the usable topology that is we use it and. Like why we use this kind of topology if we have already the bus topology or the ring topology or the star topology, right? So let's discuss that types of network topology over here. Network topology, right? So inside the network topology we are going to discuss the first topology, which is bus topology. Right, so inside the bus topology, basically how you guys are connected in that bus topology. See, this is your LAN network, right? And inside the LAN network, this is your terminator, right? From the both the side, you have the terminator, right? Now, what is the use of this terminator? So, this is your terminator, right? Now, what is the use of this terminator? It is used to block your network strength, right? It is used to block your network strength. It is used to maintain your network strength. Means, suppose that you want to go from Delhi to US, right? Or the India to US. So how you have to do? You have to some stoppage in between that, right? Suppose that this is your stoppage, which is you have UAE, right? So after that you have to take the flight from there, that UAE, and then you will take the flight after that from the US and every country, right? So basically between the India and US you have the UAE, right? So means there you have the routes, right? You have the routes that you have to reach from US. But after the US, you don't have to go anywhere, right? Or just before the India, you don't have to go anywhere, right? Means what is your business work or what is your purpose to do travel from India to US? That is. You have to work within the India and the US only, right? Means you don't have to go in the another country. So just like that, this terminator will be also work like that, right? Means it will maintain your network strength. And suppose that inside this bus topology, that is your 100 Mbps limit. So that is your 100 MB per second link that you are using it over there, right? So how you guys are connected? You guys are connected with the nodes, right? This is the nodes that you guys can connect with this LAN network, right? And here is your PC, right? So just like that, you guys are connected just like that in this bus topology, right? So we have the lots of PCs over there, right? According to our requirement, we can use the lots of PC inside our network. Okay, so basically if you want to share any data from this PC or this message, if you want to share this message from this PC to this PC, so that will share it, right? Means you can share it and you can use the 100 Mbps of the link in their LAN network, right? Suppose that if you don't have this terminator, so that network would be very long, right? The LAN network would be very long that you cannot expect it, right? And that have the lots of PCs as well in their network, right? Somebody hackers will be also there. Must they must have to, or they should have to, right? So what they can do, they can also take the, they will also receive that packet, right? So that terminator will, you can say that that will grab that particular security or that particular network which is you are using to transmit any kind of file in your local network, right? Now, what was the drawback of this burst net burst topology that we have? If we don't have this terminator, so that should be very harmful, right? Now, after that, we will have the ring topology, right? If I talk about the ring topology, so how they will work basically, let me just. So they are connected just like that, right? They are connected just like that in their rings. So suppose that this is your PC A, PC B, C, D, and, right? So these are the PC that you are connected with each other, right? Suppose that this PC A wants to share any packet or any file from the PC D, right? So that have the, this PC have the two way to reach over there, right? To the PC D. Via this way, right? Or via this way as well. So in the networking field, what we can do one thing, this PC or the any device can always follow the shorted path over there, shorted and the best path, right? So that PC A will look that that how many mediator that I have between these the PC A, the sender and the receiver, right? So this PC A will look that I have the only one mediator that is between the sender and the receiver, right? So that will choose this path as a best path, right? And that will always send this message via this path only, right? Now, the one more concept over there. This with this path will, if this PC always work, always just make this path as a passive or the backup of the path, right? If that path will be down, so this PC always choose that path, right? Via this way, right? So just like that, if any PC will go down, suppose that if any PC will go down, so we have the only one path to reach over there, right? Means that every kind of that every load and that reliability MTU, this kind of this data is going to work on that link only, right? Suppose that this is your 100 Mbps of the link, right? And you are going to share the data which is the 200 Mbps or the more than that. So this cannot handle it, because of that have some limitation, right? Because of that have some limitation. If you are you are working in that organization, so that organization always have to work on the higher storage or the higher sending and receiving process and all, right? So that is the drawback of this ring topology. Now, after that, we have the star topology. Now, if we talk about this star topology, so inside this star topology, we have just every device is connected with each other, right? Let me do that. Right, so every device is connected with each other. If that link will go down, so that have the two ways to reach from that PC, from source to destination, if any one link will go down. But if suppose that PC will go down, so that cannot use this PC in their network, right? Means you cannot use this PC in your network, right? Now we have the mesh topology after that. Mesh and the tree topology, right? So we will also talk about these topologies as well, right? And just do one thing. Just first of all, just write it down, these topology. Just make these topology, right? And then we will do continue, right? Okay. So guys, we have done this first topology and the ring topology, right? I just did some misconfiguration. I just missed one thing over there. I just made the wrong topologies, which is regarding the star topology over there, right? That the star topology, which is, you can see inside this picture, that is that your star topology, right? So inside this star topology, what was the drawback? Let me just make it. So inside this star topology, you have the switch, right? And that every device is connected with that switch on, right? Suppose that this is your switch, right? And the lots of PC is connected over on that switch, right? So that switch is, you can say that this switch is the mediator, right? If that PC wants to share any packet or any message to this PC, so that message will pass out with the pass out through this switch on, right? If suppose that this switch will goes down, so that everyone lost that connectivity, everyone will lost that connectivity, right? So to solve this problem, we have the mesh topology, right? The mesh topology, that is this, inside this mesh topology, that every PC is connected with each other, right? As you can also see in this picture, that this is your mesh topology, right? So every PC is connected with each other. Let me just. Right, so every PC is connected with each other. If that path will be goes down, so that have the two ways to reach, or two ways to reach on that PC, or that PC, or that PC as well, right? And basically that have also the one of the drawback as well. Mostly we use this mesh topology in our LAN network, right? But we have one more topology type, that is the tree topology. How the tree topologies work, let me just tell you. The tree topology have the centralized server, right? That is your server. So that every device is connected with that server. Let me just tell you. Just make it like the tree, so that you can understand. Right, this is your server, right? So that server is having the internet connectivity, or that have the LAN network, right? And that has the lots of department, right? Suppose that this is your switch, right? And that have the department, just like that we have the lots of PCs over there, right? This is your one organization, right? This is your one organization. So inside that organization, we have the lots of department, right? Suppose that this is your HR department, right? And we have also the one more department, that is account department, sales department, right? So we have lots of department, and that department is connected in that LAN network, right? And who is going to manage all kind of department? That is the server, right? Or you can say that the that founder or CEO and the founder of that particular organization, right? Who is going to maintain that? The CEO and the founder of that organization, right? Suppose that this is our account department, right? And we have also the sales department as well. So we have the lots of department according to our requirement. We can we will have the lots of department over there, and we can connect with each other. We can share the file with each other in their department only. That is where you need to share that particular folder, file, or the messages, right? So that was the network topology about the information alone, right? If we talk about extended star topology, so the extended star topology is work like if you lost the connectivity with this switch, so that have the connectivity with that switch, right? Or if you lost that connectivity of that switch, so that have the connectivity between the two switches, right? You are losing the connectivity like that this switch device is going to drop it, or that not working, but that LAN network always should have to work, right? Because of that is your LAN network, right? So that don't have any problem with that LAN network. And this hierarchy topology is work like this tree topology, right? Which is I have told you. Okay. Now if we talk about the network protocols, so these are the things, and when we will cover that definition of the OSI model and the TCP IP model, when we will describe or when we will discuss the TCP IP model and this OSI model, then I will describe these network protocols over there, right? Because of these are the totally depends upon the layers, right? So you have to first of all just understand the layers of that particular protocol source or whatever that you have. You have to first of all understand these things, then you can easily take the access of you can understand these network protocols, right?